Hi friends, welcome to Crazy for DB channel. Here we study database related concepts and languages. After studying the concept of transaction, row locking, isolation and read consistency, the next important part in transaction is how to use TCL statements. TCL stands for Transaction Control Language. These statements are commit, rollback and save point. Commit makes all the preceding pending transactions in the session permanent in the database. Once the commit is used, the rollback becomes ineffective. That means no committed changes can ever be rolled back. So to have the demonstration, let us use a few commands here. Insert into dept values say 50, training location say Tokyo, so that we have created one row, then in the dept table, then update emp set sal equals to 4000 where ename equals to say Scott. So these are the two changes I have made as a part of one transaction. So there are two changes which have been done in two different tables. One is in the dept table and the another one is in the emp table. And these two changes, if committed, when I fire a commit command over here, commit like that, semicolon, so both of these changes will be committed. Now as you select the data, select star from dpt where dptno equals to 50, so you see that new department has been created with that first insert statement. And then we'll also select the data from emp table, select star from emp where ename equals to Scott, and you can see the salary of Scott over here as 4000, which we have made okay with this statement. Earlier this salary was 3000. And so the changes are reflected in the result. Now even if we say rollback at this stage, there won't be any effect on this transaction which has been already committed. I say rollback, and though I say rollback and it says rollback complete, still if we select the data, you see that this department still exists over there, so it has not been rolled back. Even the salary of Scott also remains 4000, and the change is still remaining over there. So observe that the committed changes have not been rolled back. One more thing to remember is that if database session is ended gracefully, that is by using either exit or disconnect command, the tendency of most databases including Oracle is to commit the pending transaction of that session. So if you don't intend to retain the changes, then an explicit rollback command must be used before exiting or disconnecting the session. So in any application development, you have to remember that before the user is allowed to disconnect or exit gracefully from there, not an abnormal shutdown, then the user, if does not want to retain the changes, he should explicitly say rollback. Now as far as rollback command is concerned, all the pending changes will be rolled back. That means until the point when the transaction was started, as if no changes were ever done. So let us make again two changes to demonstrate that. So I use insert into dpt. Let me first clear the screen so that we can start all over. So it will not be confused with what we have been doing so far. Insert into DPT values, say 60, that is department number, department name is say project, the location of the department say Singapore, and another statement I am firing on the DPT table, update EMP set job equals to manager, where ename equals to say Scott. Scott has been analyst, but now we are changing his job to manager with this statement, and now there are these two changes as you can see. And now if I say roll back at this stage, both of these changes will be rolled back. So rollback basically takes your database to a state where before the point in time this insert into DPT statement was fired. So I will show you that. Select star from DPT where DPTNO equals to 60, DPTNO equals to 60. As you can see, there is no row selected message. So that row which we have inserted have gone. In the same way, let us see, not update, select star from EMP where ename equals to Scott. And so you see that, as I told you, Scott has been analyst. We had changed his jobs to job to manager over here, but because of this rollback, the job has again been rolled back to the original, that is analyst. So rollback takes place to the point where the transaction actually started. But now consider a case where the user has been doing a batch job, in which the user has a series of DML operations to carry out before I need to say commit. Here I have created that sort of scenario. Now say in the nth transaction, this DML nth change, the user has committed, I mean he has done some mistake over here. Now as far as this DML, this DML 2 and DML 3 has been okay, fine, but as far as this DML is concerned, here in this case there has been some mistake done by the user. Now if he says rollback over here, just rollback, then the entire thing will be rolled back to the point when the transaction T1 actually started. But we don't want that, because all these DMLs that user has fired so far, they were right, they were correct, and so we don't want to roll back to this point, otherwise this entire thing will be required to be done by the user again, and all his efforts will be nullified, and so we don't want this to happen. So there we have created save points in between each of these DML, like DML 1 and DML 2 we have created a save point A, similarly DML 2 and DML 3 we have created save point B, and so on. So DML N is also preceded with a save point say M over here, and I can say here, sorry, that should be rollback to M, I should have written rollback to M, so that only this much change which was wrongly done by the user will be rolled back. Now remember that save point does not save any changes, it only allows you to return to a point where subsequent changes were as if never made. beyond this point, as if this change was never made. So it actually takes you to this particular point, and so it helps us to conserve the efforts that have been put by the user since beginning of the transaction. Now we will demonstrate this practically over in the Oracle session. For example, consider a case of creation of two departments in the DPT table, and then inserting rows of employees in ENP table in those two departments. So that is our case. I will create two departments over here. Before that, again I will clear the screen so that there should not be any confusion. Whatever we have been doing preceding to this exercise. So insert into DPT values 70, say testing department, and the department is Delhi. So that is the new department created of testing, having number 70 and location at Delhi. Then another insert into DPT. We were supposed to create two departments as per our problem. Then 80, department name is planning, and the location is say Bangalore. So two departments have been created. Sorry, we will have to roll back that they had to be created with save points in between, which we have not done. So insert into forget about that operation that we have done. We are doing it afresh. DPT values 70, testing, Delhi. Then I have to create a save point A. Then another insert statement here. So most part is same, so I will get copied it down. 80, testing, and Bangalore. Then I will create a save point B over there. Then to proceed, I will insert two rows of EMP in respectively these two departments, 70 and 80. So insert into EMP NO, ename, job, DPT NO, then values 1122, that is employee number, say employee name is Robert, then his manager, and his department number 70. So we put him into department number 70. So that is an employee created, Robert. Insert into EMP again, most part is because same, so I will just copy it down from there. Then values, that part also can be copied. Okay, 1123, another, and then Tony, then analyst, and then department number 60. Sorry, again I have to create save point C, and then create this row actually. Okay, values 1123, the name of the employee Tony, he is an analyst, and department number 80, as you can see. Okay, I have created save point over there, save point C before this change. So now, as you see, that user has made a mistake. He was supposed to insert this name as Tony, whereas the spelling has been wrong. And so now, if the user has to correct it, in normal case, what user would require to do is that he would say rollback at this point, and the rollback will take place up to this entire session. All the changes would be rollback, which is obviously a very cumbersome activity. So if we just want to make the change here, we don't want to go that far to roll back everything. We can say rollback to C, and you see, with this rollback to C command, the changes have been rolled back only to the point before this insert was done. This insert was done, and so you can see that we will repeat that insert again, but with the correct name now. So insert values, and this time that mistake we had deliberately done, because we wanted to show you that for that small mistake, you don't have to roll back the entire change. So analyst, then 80, and of course now we have taken care that the name has been spelled correctly. As you can see here, Tony has been spelled as T-O-N-Y, and now one row created. And now if I commit, only the correct data has been committed. You will see that select star from DEPT. So you will see that both of these departments are there. This is 70 and this is department number 80 over there. So actually, this rollback to C statement didn't roll back it to the point where the first insert was done. So that has been proved. Similarly, I will show you the data of EMP table also. Select star from EMP. semicolon and enter. Oh, sorry. Select star from EMP. And so you can see that this Robert and Tony. Now this Robert exists, so this was not rolled back with the rollback to C command. And moreover, the Tony that was inserted with the wrong spelling, now the spelling is correct over here. So that proves that the save point actually is of much help when we are dealing with a series of changes to be made as a part of single transaction. So now is the time to take your leave, guys, and for you to answer the test question, which you may find in the description box below. Answer the question in the comment. It could be an interview question, so do not avoid it. Subscribe to the channel if you have not done so far. Click on the bell icon also on the like button. Thanks for watching. Thank you.